Well, good evening, everyone, and welcome to Burbank Ice Arena in Reading, Massachusetts. I'm Paul McNamara here for My Hockey Live tonight. We're here to bring you all the action between the hometown Reading Rockets and the visiting Harbormen from Hingham. They've come up from the South Shore along with their 8-1-2 record, and they invade Burbank tonight. Reading sitting at 5-4, but 5-1 in the league thus far. It's great to have you with us on a busy Saturday night. It's midwinter in New England, so what better time is it for high school hockey here in eastern Massachusetts? Kevin Booth is with us tonight from SerialVideo.com, ready to produce and make sure you don't miss one play tonight. This is an intersectional rivalry, as we said, and a non-league battle. Reading, of course, an independent, and they play a totally independent schedule. They don't have a league to play league games in, of course. But Reading plays in the tough Middlesex League, and they've been a strong hockey team for years. Great tradition of hockey in Reading. Long time under Peter Doherty, and now Peter's son Mark Doherty has been the coach for a long time here as well, and does a great job. And of course, Tony Messina and his crew down the other end with the Hingham Harbormen doing a tremendous job as well. And now we're going to have the introduction of the starting lineups tonight. Of course, Ed Peduto, the great rink manager here at Burbank, will introduce the starting lineups. And for Hingham, starting up front will be Drew Hickey, the senior, number 19. He'll skate with number 26, Jack Hennessy, the senior, in the middle. And on left wing, number 27, Jeff Gordon, another senior. On defense, the starting pair will be sophomore Jake Higgins and co-captain Mark O'Rourke. And in net will be number 30, Robbie Kornack, the junior, who has had a tremendous year for the Harbormen, taking over the full-time role this year. And for the Rockets, starting at center, co-captain Kevin Tobin, the fantastic athlete. You won't see him stop all night, Kevin Tobin. Brendan Donovan, the sophomore, number 27, will skate at one wing with Kevin Tobin, and Kevin's brother Michael Tobin, number 19, will skate the other wing, also a sophomore. On defense, Jack Conte, the senior, and Nick Mealy, the other co-captain, junior, number 22, will play D as a starting defenseman for Reading. And in goal tonight, Matt Coughlin, the junior, and right now, our national anthem. Well, we're about set for the opening drop of the puck. I want to thank Sullivan Tire. If you're looking for exceptional auto service, head on down to Sullivan Tire. Family owned and operated, they've been serving New England for over 60 years. Their highly trained staff will give you a hand with any of your auto needs. Sullivan Tire offers brand name tires and parts at a price that can't be beat. They're always here to get you there. Sullivan Tire and Auto Centers. And we want to thank the Department of Recreation and Conservation for their support here at My Hockey Live. The Mass Department of Conservation and Recreation is actively recruiting lifeguards to fill summer lifeguard jobs. If you're a qualified swimmer and are interested in applying for a summer lifeguard position, it's a great opportunity to do what you love and make $1,060 every 2 weeks this summer. Visit masslifeguard.com to register today. Masslifeguard.com and make $1,060 every 2 weeks this summer as a lifeguard. We'll be telling you more about the Department of Recreation and Conservation and Sullivan Tire as we move forward, but we thank them for their support of high school hockey. A little bit of equipment issue down to our left. Goaltender Robbie Kornack signaled the officials to come check out the net and make sure it was where it's supposed to be. And now the crowd is into it, and the puck is dropped, and we're underway. Back in the Reading net end. It's sent up the right wing side. Kevin Tobin knocks it to center. Michael Tobin gives chase. Back to get it, knocking away is Higgins. They get it out to center. That's Jake Higgins. There are a couple of Higgins players on this Hingham team. Number four is the younger brother, Jake, the sophomore. He'll send it behind the net to Mark O'Rourke, quickly up on the left wing to Gordon. Gordon in the middle. His hands off to Hickey, but can't get by the Reading defense outside the blue line. Kevin Tobin, nice play to get back and send it to center. Mark O'Rourke with a long wrister in. Saved there by Coughlin as Hingham will try to change up. And now it's dumped in deep by Brendan Donovan for Reading. New five on the ice for Hingham and as well for Reading. Up at center ice, this is Jake Quilty trying to get it in the zone. Jacobs helps out and supports and sends it in deep, and now it's sent in this way by Tommy Kornack. Behind the net, tango for Reading. Up the right wing breakout, this is Jay Gallagher on the go. A 2-on-1, Gallagher can't get it by Tommy Kornack. Nice play there, as headed to the net all alone was Ryan Gallagher. The Gallagher brothers with a 2-on-1, but stymied by Kornack. Now behind the net, Jacobs over to Kornack near side, right up the middle to Hickey. His pocket is picked clean. A nice save, and it's kicked in the goal by Jacobs, by his goaltender Kornack. And James Riley is going to get credit for a goal. Very quickly on, Reading takes the lead. It comes at a minute 26. It'll be Riley's goal for Reading. It should be unassisted. They may throw a couple on there, but it's a 1-0 game. Reading right out of the gate, kicked in by a Reading defenseman inadvertently. Now behind the net, Higgins knocks it off the boards for O'Rourke. They clear it up to center. On the go for Reading is, for Hingham rather, and taken down is 14, Jack Grady. I think we're going to get a penalty call here. So Jay Gallagher picks up an assist on the Riley goal. No penalty on the call. It's the whistle just for the net coming off. In some rinks, that's a hook or a hold, but not here tonight. Breaking it out now is Brendan Donovan. Up for Tobin. Michael Tobin's shot goes wide and high. Mealy hustles up, keeps it in at the line. Gets it behind the net to Michael Tobin. Tobin loses to O'Rourke. It's stolen away by Donovan. Donovan trying to cycle it, intercepted by O'Rourke, who flips it up the center over the head of Mealy and deep into the Reading end, and icing is called here. Brendan Donovan, a compliment to the Tobin brothers. Good hustle there, and a good play by O'Rourke to get it out of danger. Now Drew Hickey's line comes out for Hingham, and squaring off for Reading on the faceoff will be Jay Gallagher, number 9. He's out there with Ryan Gallagher and James Riley. Now Gallagher is waved out, and Riley will step in. James Riley on the draw with Hickey, goes right to Jay Gallagher on the boards, and a quick shot and a save by Kornack there. So Gallagher will go back in and take this draw. Him not being there kind of worked for Reading. And now it's loose underneath. Gallagher gets a shot off the draw from the loose puck. It goes wide. Riley back on the boards, all the way back to Tango. His shot bounces in wide, and Jacobs will start up this way for Hingham. Kept in at the line by Andrew McKaylee. McKaylee, number 5 for Reading now. And good job by Gallagher at the line to hustle back and send it in deep. It's sent around by Caleb Wooden. Wooden, number 33, gets it up the middle to Hickey. Hickey, good back check there by Ryan Gallagher. Hickey gets it again. They can't get it in deep, and now Gordon is out there for Hingham. But Tango for Reading sends it around behind to McKaylee. McKaylee up the wing for number 17, Matt Farwell. Farwell runs into traffic right in front of the Hingham bench below us. And now stepping up is Jack Conte for Reading at center ice, and they're able to get it in deep. Jacobs back on it for the Harbormen. He gives in the middle to Will Dentremont, but they have trouble clearing near side. It's a good play by 14, Brendan Donaghy for Reading, and now it's loose, and Farwell knocks it in deep for the Rockets. Behind the net is Caleb Wooden, and Hingham finally able to break it out. This is Dentremont. He'll dump it in deep. Stopped behind the net by Coughlin. The Reading goaltender. And now it's in the Reading end, and they play catch, the defensemen do, and it goes over to Conte, who lugs it to center over the red line, but stopped there by 24, John Sullivan. Nice play by Hingham. And now Kornack up the wing for 28, Pat McGahan. And now it's back on the Reading back line, and Mealy will skate it up over the red line and dump it in deep smartly. Stopped behind the net by goaltender Kornack. O'Rourke is wearing Kevin Tobin as he heads back there. And now Sullivan can't get it clear, and they get it around to Kornack, the defenseman. Kornack will turn and go the other way as Michael Tobin does a good job of forechecking. Now they kick it over on the wall to Pat McGahan. McGahan's centering pass up the middle, can't clear, but now good job by Frankie Higgins to hustle up and muscle it in, but not deep. Jack Conte will play it over to Mealy. Mealy sends it deep, and icing will be the call as he was trying to hit Kevin Tobin up over the red line. And misses connections there, and icing will be called with 10:22 to go in the first period of play, and Reading on top, 1-0 at the moment. It was an early goal. It was credited to James Riley. It was actually knocked in by a Hingham defenseman on a bouncing puck that came early at the 1:26 mark. We're about 5 minutes in now, and they wave both number nines out of there. Gallagher for Reading and Frankie Higgins for Hingham. Now, Andrew Driscoll will step in and take it against Riley. They get it near side. Gallagher can't bang it past Jake Higgins. Higgins sends it in deep. Back on it is Nick Tango for Reading. They try the right wing breakout, and here's Jay Gallagher. He can't find the handle. He had a step on everyone from Hingham for the moment. And now good job by Higgins to send Gallagher to the boards. Ryan Gallagher now falls down and can't get it to a teammate, and it's stolen this side by Caleb Wooden. Wooden will get it out of the zone, but not for long as Ryan Gallagher turns and fires it back in deep, and Reading goes on a change. Puck is flipped high by Hingham into the Reading end. It caroms down near the goaltender Coughlin, and it's picked up down there by Anthony DeVolio. Reading on the break. Donaghy muscles his way in. It goes to Jacobs, who bangs it around on the far boards to Quilty. Quilty gets it out of the zone, but not very far as Reading knocks it right back in deep. Jacobs will have to play it again. Comes near side for Will Kenny. And a long pass on the left side to Quilty. Quilty in, a shot, a save. It's kicked right into the goaltender by the defenseman, Mealy. Good play by Coughlin, and Reading able to clear. Best chance of the evening so far for Hingham right there as Quilty took it down the left wing inside the circle and let go a blistering shot, but nice play by Coughlin, who had his pad square and able to make that save. Biggest problem was on the rebound. Grady now on the draw for Hingham as Kevin Tobin is waved out, and Michael Tobin will step in to square off with Grady. Controlled by Hingham, knocked in deep by Matt Kenny, but Reading able to clear. At center ice, this is Jacobs. Jacobs will send it in deep. Stopped by Coughlin, and a long pass up to Michael Tobin. Tobin on the go. It's a 2-on-3. Tobin in the middle. Wrist shot saved there by Kornack, and he'll hang on. Folks, we'd be remiss if we didn't say there's a seat missing tonight. First time I've been in the building since the passing of Charlie Driscoll, a familiar face around the Reading rink, and a great man in Massachusetts hockey who passed away a couple of weeks ago. Here's Hingham on the go, 3-on-2. Far side, it's Clark, the shot saved by Coughlin there. Jacob Clark with a good wrister, but Reading able to turn and come the other way. It's Tobin to Tobin, Michael to Kevin. Kevin trying to go through the trees there. And broken up by O'Rourke first, and then a back-checking Jake Higgins, his defense partner. DeVolio overskates at his own line, picked up by Clark, 1-on-3. Clark's stick handle's knocked away by Mealy, and now Donovan tries to post Mealy in. Clark is tripped up. Play continues. Michael Tobin goes back to get it. Tobin spins and knocks it off the boards and high into the Hingham end. No icing here as Higgins back on it. We'll play it to O'Rourke. O'Rourke now quickly up the left wing, intended for Jack Hennessy. Hennessy will go over to Gordon. Gordon over the line. Gordon, a wrist shot blocked by the defense. O'Rourke jumps up into the play from his defense spot, but he loses in the corner. Now Riley trying to stick handle on the far side past Hickey. Can't do so. O'Rourke still in deep. This is O'Rourke, turns and fires, but it hits the body of Mealy up high. Higgins quickly over and a shot, a save by Coughlin. Through a screen. Matt Coughlin never saw that one, but he was perfectly positioned and made the save. Whistle goes and the faceoff's gonna come outside the zone here. Riley is bent over, and Riley's gonna get a misconduct here. It's gonna come at 7:27. He's going to get a minor for unsportsmanlike, I believe. Whatever the call, Hingham's on the power play, I believe. So it's a minor to Riley, and Hingham will go on the power play here. They get it back to O'Rourke. Over to Jacobs, one-timer goes wide, looking for the top right corner. Good angle from here. O'Rourke hands it off to Hennessy. Hennessy looking in front, wide open. It's loose. It's covered up for the moment now. Hennessy on the rebound, and a goal as it's knocked in by Coughlin. Jack Grady was on the doorstep. Hennessy was on the doorstep. We'll see whom they give the goal to, but I believe it was knocked in by Coughlin, but it ties the game, a power play goal. It'll come at the 7:44 mark. We'll have to wait for that announcement, but however it comes out, it's a 1-1 hockey game now. Power play goal for Hingham. And they're on the go again here. This is 18, Jake Quilty knocking it in deep behind Coughlin. Quickly back to get it is DeVolio. Can't get it by the forecheck of Andrew Driscoll. And now Michael Tobin gets it to the line and out. Kevin Tobin on the go. He's held up by Frankie Higgins. No call there. And O'Rourke breaks it up, trying to get a pass to Driscoll. Hits Higgins in the skates. O'Rourke will send it in deep. Tango back on it for the Rockets. The minor was for unsportsmanlike conduct to Riley. Here's Hingham on the breakout. Cornack trying to find Quilty on the far side. Can't connect. And back on it is Mealy. Mealy can't connect with Jay Gallagher. And Higgins back on it for Hingham. Cross ice behind the net to Cornack. Cornack's long pass up to Jacob Clark, intercepted by Redding and knocked in, but Cornack with it again. Cornack off the boards, or rather wing to wing to Kenny. He can't get it in deep, and Redding knocks it in to the Redding end, to the Hingham end. They try the left wing breakout, and it's kept in by Redding. Backhander blocked by Cornack off the stick of number 12, Ryan Driscoll. Now Kenny will circle it around, intended for Higgins. Higgins far side to Clark. He loses at the line, and it's knocked in deep by Matt Farwell. Redding with some pressure here, and they try to hit Mealy near side, and it jumps out of the zone. Mealy right back the other way, intended for Ryan Driscoll. Driscoll covered up by Higgins. Clark helps out for Hingham, and Farwell helps out for Redding. Kept in at the line by Ryan Driscoll. Here's a move by Kevin Tobin. And he runs into a wall there in O'Rourke. And Jake Higgins flips it out of the zone and down deep, giving chases Dentremont on Mealy. Mealy able to get it around to Conti. And here's Kevin Tobin going down the near side. Kevin Tobin stops over the line. Shot the flex off the stick of Caleb Wooden into the far corner. Dentremont finally able to get it out, but Kevin Tobin's right there and bangs it off the glass. 4:42 to go, first period of play now. We are tied at one. Puck goes up the left wing for John Sullivan. He can't get it past the back check of 27, Donovan for Redding. Donovan knocks it in the zone, but picked up there by O'Rourke. O'Rourke trying to hit Sullivan up the left side. Can't connect, and down comes Tango. His pass intercepted by Sullivan on the back check. Sullivan now over the red line, flips it in deep right wing corner. Back to get it is DeVolio for Redding. He swings it up the left wing for Gallagher. Gallagher loses to Hennessy. Hennessy off the boards to himself in the high slot, intended for Hickey. Hickey swung and missed on that one. Puck is loose, and Jay Gallagher now knocks it in deep and gives chase. Back to get it is Caleb Wooden for the Harbormen. Elusive puck as Hennessy finally able to try to get it up to Hickey. And he gets it back to Hennessy over the line, but he runs into three Rockets there. Hennessy knocks it down with his left leg and goes down the left wing. Hennessy throws it back, intended for Jacobs. Jacobs sends a long one in. There's about five Harbormen still in the zone. Okay, two. They finally get it out, and Mealy now swings around as Gordon does a good job of forechecking. DeVolio now up the near side, intended for Farwell. Back to get it is Kornak. Long pass right onto the stick of Gordon, who gets it over the line and dumps it in deep after he takes a hit from Giuliotti. Redding will try the left wing breakout, but intercepted there by Driscoll. Driscoll's shot goes wide, and it's covered up by number nine, Frankie Higgins. Driscoll trying to bang in the corner, loses, and Farwell will start out for the Rockets. Loses to Higgins at center ice, who flips it in deep. Back to get it is Giuliotti. Giuliotti for Redding. A lot of ice in front of him. 2:49 to go, first period. Tied at one. Giuliotti smartly dumps it in. Picked up back there by Jake Higgins. Higgins up the left wing for 18, Jake Quilty. Quilty leaves it in the middle for Grady. Grady in deep and scores! Jack Grady on a tough angle. Puts Hingham in front, 2-1 with 2:33 to go in the first period. Hickey will get one assist. That's going to come at 12:27 of period number one. Grady with a snipe. Tough angle. I believe it was Quilty who will get one assist from Grady. We'll check the scoring between periods, folks, but that was Grady's goal to make it 2-1. Grady does get the goal. Well, they give an assist to Higgins. We'll give an MHL assist to Quilty. Nonetheless, it's 2-1 Hingham. As we approach, and now we're under 2 minutes to go in the first period. Jacobs, long rink width pass intended for Jacob Clark, bounces over his stick. Back to get it's DeVolio. DeVolio trying to play it off the boards, and Jacobs, who was in deep, able to steal it and send it back in behind the Redding net. DeVolio now trying to lug it up the right side, and it's kept in on a nice play at the line by 28, Pat McGahan. Behind the net, trying to center it as Sullivan can't get it in front. Now it comes to the line and Redding able to break it out. This is Riley over the line. Riley trying to get around Higgins, and O'Rourke comes back out of nowhere and steals it. They toss it across ice. Higgins goes up the left, Jake Higgins goes up the left side. Here's a two-on-one in deep. Sullivan trying to lay it in front, intended for McGahan, and can't get through the Redding defense. Riley now will send it up for Jay Gallagher. Gallagher is met immediately by Drew Hickey. And Redding finally able to bring it out. It's Gallagher. It's a two-on-one. It's Gallagher and Gallagher in. Jay Gallagher shot. Saved by Kornak. Tried to time that as brother Ryan was headed to the net. Jay Gallagher again behind the net. Centering pass goes off the stick of Kornak, the inside of the stick, and right across the goal line. And out safely. Now a shot is blocked by the trees on its way in and cleared by Jake Higgins. Mealy right back in for Redding. And offsides is whistled here as Mealy took his body over the line before the puck. And I think Kevin Tobin might have been over the line near side anyway. But offsides is called with 21.9 seconds to go in the first period. And Hingham leading it 2-1. The Tobin line out there against the Hickey line. Both lines that started the hockey game. And now the clearing pass is fanned partially by Jacobs. They need to get it out under 11 seconds left. And here's a break. Gordon going the other way down to 9 seconds. Gordon, the shot goes up into the netting and knocks another puck out with 5.9 to go in the first period of play. Jeff Gordon quickly got over the line, took two strides to the left and let go a snapshot that went high over the net. Face off to the left now of goaltender Coughlin in the Redding end as the clock winds down with the puck in the corner. And the buzzer will go, ending the first period of play. And it was a lively one. 3 goals in the period. At 1:26, Redding took the lead on a goal by James Riley with assist to Jay Gallagher. That made it 1-0 Redding. Then at 7:44, Hingham answered on the power play. We got to check that scoring for you as it was a flurry in front. And I think actually went in off the Redding goaltender, but we'll check the official scoring for you on that. It was a power play goal at 7:44, tied the game at 1. And then at 12:27, Hingham took the lead on a goal by Jack Grady, the senior forward. Assist was given to Jake Higgins, and we would also give an assist to Quilty, Jake Quilty, on the play. That made it 2-1. An even strength goal came at 12:27, as we said, and that's where we stand after one period of play. Only one penalty in the first period. It was a minor to Redding, to Riley, and as a result of that penalty, Hingham was able to tie the game with a power play goal. So it meant something, that penalty. We're going to take a break right now, but we want to remind you, all season long, we are brought to you by a couple of great sponsors, Sullivan Tire. If you're looking for exceptional auto service, head on down to Sullivan Tire. Family owned and operated, they've been serving New England for over 60 years. Their highly trained staff will give you a hand with any of your auto needs. Sullivan Tire offers brand name tires and parts at a price that can't be beat. They're always here to get you there. Sullivan Tire and Auto Centers. And folks, the Department of Recreation and Conservation of the Commonwealth of Massachusetts would like you to know they are actively recruiting lifeguards to fill summer lifeguard jobs. If you are a qualified swimmer and are interested in applying for a summer lifeguard position, this is a great opportunity to do what you love and make $1,060 every 2 weeks. Visit masslifeguard.com, masslifeguard.com to register today, masslifeguard.com. We'll take a break right now between periods as they make ice, and we'll be back with the second period between Hingham and Redding in a few minutes, folks. After one, it is Hingham 2 and Redding 1. Hingham comes out of the gate for period number two and scores the third goal. Wow. Jack Hennessy's going to get the goal, and it's going to come at 11 seconds of the second period. Hingham 3, Redding 1 now, very quickly in the second period, and right now we're going to get a penalty. A slashing call. I believe it's going to be Jeff Gordon headed to the box for Hingham. Gordon for slashing. This is going to come at 17 seconds. So the first power play opportunity of the evening for Redding, and a chance to cut the lead in half. Jay Gallagher will man the right point. They get into the corner. Kevin Tobin around the boards looking for Mealy. Mealy comes in deep. Hennessy challenges there. They get it to Kevin Tobin. Two players for each team behind the net. Picked out of there by Michael Tobin. Now behind the net. Intercepted by Jacobs for Hingham. And skated out by Hennessy, the most recent goal scorer. Hennessy able to knock it off the boards to himself. He's in close and a save by Coughlin. A big one there. They send Michael Tobin away one on two. Michael Tobin tries a toe drag. Hickey and Higgins pick up the assist on the Hennessy goal, making it 3-1, and Hingham able to clear with 41 seconds to go on the power play for Redding. Jay Gallagher back to pick it up and leave it for Kevin Tobin, who gives it back to Gallagher. Gallagher out in front of his own net, looks up for Michael Tobin, loses it in his skates, and Andrew Driscoll flips it back in for the Harbormen. 25 seconds on the power play now for Redding. Puck in the Redding end. They kick it to center ice, but Jake Higgins on it there. He'll go D to D, near side to O'Rourke, back to Higgins, killing time. 13 seconds now of power play time left for Redding. Trying to pick it away in the Redding end is Frankie Higgins. Frankie Higgins bats at it, and Gallagher picks it up. Jay Gallagher around the net for Mealy. Penalty is over to Gordon for Hingham, and they are back to full strength. And now offsides is whistled here with 13:05 to go, second period. Well, it's not offsides. It's a zone violation on Hingham, and the penalty, the faceoff's going to come back to the left of their goaltender Kornack, Robbie Kornack, for Hingham. 13 minutes to go, second period of play just underway, and it's 3-1 Hingham. It was 2-1 after one period of play, and 11 seconds into this period, Jack Hennessy struck for Hingham, giving the Harbormen a two-goal lead at this point. Hingham survived a penalty early in this period. Redding not able to convert. And that's where we are right now. Here's Tommy Kornack over to Jacobs. Up for Jacob Clark. Clark gets it in the zone, but not deep, as it's knocked away by the Rockets and Brendan Donaghy. This is Donaghy giving chase right in front of his own bench over the line. Donaghy inside the circle. His shot is half negated by Grady. They get it up to Driscoll, who flips it in deep, and Jacob Clark on the go for Hingham. Tries to take it away, but Tango does a nice job for Redding and able to get it up the boards for 17, Matt Farwell. Farwell dumps and they will change. Behind the net is Wooden. Wooden for Hingham, long rink width pass onto the stick of Pat McGagan. And his redirect goes right in on Coughlin, who covers up. And the faceoff will come to his left with 11:54 to go, middle period of play. Hingham leading it 3-1. Dentremont will square off for Hingham against Kevin Tobin for the Rockets. Tobin wins it right into the corner for Gigliotti. Gigliotti bangs it around the boards and takes a hit from Dentremont. Dentremont takes a big hit from Mealy, but Mealy goes down. Now Michael Tobin trying to muscle his way down the boards, and we're going to get a hand closing on the puck infraction call on Brendan Donovan just below us. And they're going to drop that puck just outside the blue line of Redding, as both teams will take an opportunity to change here. Now they're going to call it in the Redding zone, as it was a Redding infraction. And Hickey will square off with Jay Gallagher, controlled by nobody. And now it goes to Hennessy, who's knocked down and loses it to DeVolio. DeVolio banks it off behind the net, looking for Gallagher on the far side. Stepping in is Tango, who can't get it by Big O'Rourke at the line. Hingham able to keep it in, and now Riley trying to get it to Gallagher, stolen by Gordon. Gordon, a backhander, saved by Coughlin. He lost it for a moment, but had his left leg in the right position, using his leg and the post to make that save. DeVolio has his pocket picked clean. It's a 3-on-1 in close. Shot by Gordon. He hit the post. After a beautiful setup by Drew Hickey, Gordon just had to go off a little bit the side of his stick blade and went off the post. Wow, he'll be seeing that one in his dreams. Long pass up by Wooden for Hennessy, who gets a stick on it to negate the icing. And Hingham will change. Quickly, Redding trying to take advantage of that. They send a long one up for Farwell, but he can't control, and back to get it is Jake Higgins. Higgins gets it over to Jacobs, and quickly over the other side to Driscoll. A wrist shot saved by Coughlin for Redding. Rebound goes right out to Ryan Driscoll, trying to find Farwell in the middle. Can't connect. And Higgins tries to find Driscoll for Hingham up the far side. Driscoll will try to get it in again, but Tango able to intercept it halfway deep. Tango knocks it up the sideboards onto the stick of Jake Higgins, who gives it to Driscoll. Driscoll trying to leave it there for Frankie Higgins. Kind of a lot of center ice play at the moment. Jacobs now hustles over and sends it deep into the right wing corner. Karams all the way out to Farwell, who's pinned by Higgins. And now Jake, that's Frankie Higgins, and Jake Higgins supports and sends it in deep, but out come the Rockets. This is Ryan Driscoll going cross ice for Farwell, trying to hit Kevin Tobin on the go, but intercepted by Hingham, and they've got some ice on the far side. This is Frankie Higgins, leads it to Jake Higgins. Shot goes wide. Higgins to Higgins, can't connect. Jacob Clark hustles back and has it poked off his stick by Kevin Tobin. Now Tommy Kornack sends it over on the far side to Higgins. Up ice. This is number 37, Will Kenny, in deep for the Harbormen. It goes to Jacob Clark. He's watched by 25, Conti. Jake Conti trying to pin Clark against the boards. Nice play to get it back on the point to 21, Matt Kenny. His wrist shot is stopped on the way in, and now Michael Tobin picks it up loose on the far side. Michael Tobin gets it by Kornack over to Donovan, but Donovan can't control, and Conti steps up and sends it in deep as Hingham tries to change. They're down a man on the changeup. Good job by Jay Gallagher to come over and pick it up. We apologize, we have a problem when the puck comes deep into the right wing corner, but now a good bid by Hingham. That is 24, John Sullivan, whose shot goes wide. Caroms all the way back. into his own end of the ice. A quick moving second period. We're down to 8:18 left in period number two. It is 3-1 Hingham with the lead. Jacobs now starts up the right side. Jacobs all the way into the Reading end. Jacobs inside the circle, broken up by Jay Gallagher to Ryan Gallagher. Ryan Gallagher can't get it out of the zone. Nice play by Will Dentremont to backhand it in deep. And Dentremont to steal it. And now good support by O'Rourke all the way down from the point as McGagan couldn't pick it up as he was challenged by the Reading defense. But O'Rourke was more than happy to step into the fray and send a shot in on net that Coughlin was able to stop. Break in the action, 7:46 to go. Second period of play, 3-1 Hingham with the lead. Face off in the Reading end, they get it back to Jacobs. Jacobs threw a screen, it's deflected, and good job by Matt Coughlin, the senior goalie, to follow that redirect. Brendan Donaghy on the draw here for Reading against Drew Hickey. Hickey able to win it to Hennessy. Hennessy skates up high into the slot, shot blocked by the stick of Tango, who gets it out of the zone. And Hennessy has to travel back into his own end of the ice, circles wide in front of his own net, trying to get Hickey off the boards over there. A nice play by Davolio to step up for Reading. But now it goes to O'Rourke. O'Rourke looking for Hennessy. Davolio got his stick in the way. Good back check here by Ryan Driscoll. But equally good play by Hickey, who can't get it in deep now. They get it to center. O'Rourke on the go. O'Rourke, the rushing defenseman, wicked wrist shot. Up high, saved by Coughlin. Great bid by O'Rourke. Hingham buzzing at the moment. Now Jacobs skips it in. Tango has to bank it off the boards. It doesn't go deep. Centering pass by Gordon, blocked by Davolio. They get it back to the right point to Higgins. Higgins a shot through a screen, never makes it in. Davolio up the boards, intercepted by Gordon on the far side. Jeff Gordon deep into the corner. They get it to Frankie Higgins. Frankie Higgins turns and cycles it deep. Over this way, Tommy Kornack, the defenseman, goes in deep. Comes behind the net to Brendan Donaghy for Reading. They can't control it and get it out. Davolio now, Reading needs a whistle badly. Great forechecking by Hingham. This is Driscoll. Back to Kornack, walks to the middle. Kornack finds an open man. A turn and a shot by Quilty, blocked by the pads of the defense. Kornack sends it in deep, and Tango intercepts, trying to get it over the red line. Tango off the boards will follow it in. And Jake Higgins circles it away and sends Driscoll away on the far side. He's one on two. Driscoll turns, slows down, leaves it for Kornack. Kornack, a wrist shot save in front by the goaltender Coughlin. It's loose and now kicked to the corner. Kornack in deep, finds an open man in front. That is Grady. His shot is blocked, and here come the Rockets. They come the other way. This is going to be offsides as there was a hold up at the line, and Donovan had to go wide, and Kevin Tobin was headed down Main Street over the line, a hair ahead of the puck, and offsides is the call, the correct call. 5:39 to go, second period of play, 3-1 Hingham. Kevin Tobin almost a shot on net from outside the line off the faceoff. O'Rourke back on it. Knocks it off the boards for Will Kenny. Gets it up to center, intended for Grady. Grady is spilled. Puck loose at center. Gigliotti knocks it in deep. Bouncing puck onto the stick of O'Rourke right in front of his own goaltender, Kornack. O'Rourke spins away from a forecheck and tries to find Kenny on the far side. That would have been icing, except it went right in on net. O'Rourke trying to hit his right wing Kenny on the far side. It went off the boards. And a perfect pool cue shot went right in on goaltender Coughlin, who had to make the save with 5:12 to go, causing a faceoff in his end of the ice. Different line out there for Hingham now, as they've got Kenny on the right wing, Grady in the middle, and Jacob Clark. And now a timeout is called by Reading with 5:12 to go in the middle period of play. Remember, folks, Sullivan Tire, if you're looking for exceptional auto service, head on down to Sullivan Tire. Family owned and operated, they've been serving New England for over 60 years. Their highly trained staff will give you a hand with any of your auto needs. Sullivan Tire offers brand name tires and parts at a price that can't be beat. They're always here to get you there. Sullivan Tire and Auto Centers. and the Department of Recreation and Conservation, another proud sponsor of My Hockey Live. The Massachusetts Department of Conservation and Recreation is actively recruiting lifeguards to fill summer lifeguard jobs. If you are a qualified swimmer and are interested in applying for a summer lifeguard position, this is a great opportunity to do what you love and make $1,060 every 2 weeks. Visit masslifeguard.com to register today. That's masslifeguard.com. So to reset the game, 5:12 to go, middle period. One goal in the game for Reading, three for Hingham. Hingham leads it 3-1. The goals belong to Riley, and I don't think they've got the right goal scorer on the second one for Hingham. I think it was Jeff Gordon. Grady got the third goal, and Hennessy the fourth goal. The goal scorer for Reading was James Riley early on in the first period of play. Play underway in the Reading end of the ice. Hingham has had a flurry the last 5 or 6 minutes with great forechecking. This is Gordon. Gordon will backhand it over looking for O'Rourke. Bounces off his boots onto the stick of Jay Gallagher. Gallagher will start a 2-on-1 if he hustles. Gallagher in. Centering pass is going to be a penalty call here on Hennessy as C.J. Hart, just inserted in the lineup, was headed for the net and was tripped up by Hennessy. And Redding's going to go on the power play here with 4:29 to go. It's a hook on Hennessy, a minor. Comes at 10:31. So the second power play opportunity of this period for the Rockets. They'd love to get one here and cut the lead to a goal. The Tobin brothers are out there. Jay Gallagher's out there. Mealy's out there. And James Riley's out there. A lot of veterans. They get it to Kevin Tobin, but a bouncing puck is stolen by Jeff Gordon. Gordon to the red line and flips it in. Here's Kevin Tobin with a head of steam. Kevin Tobin all the way up the right side. Over the line. Tobin trying to get around Jacobs. Gets around the net. Centers it off the side of the net. Picked up by Michael Tobin. Michael Tobin in the corner. One hands it across the ice for Kevin Tobin in the corner to Riley. He's pinned by Jacobs. Puck is loose now to Michael Tobin to Kevin Tobin. He's got an open man at the point. Now Michael Tobin gets it back to Mealy through a screen. Saved there by Kornack. It was the right play, but there was no traffic, no screen there. And Kornack was able to see it all the way and make the stop. 40 seconds to go on the man advantage for the Rockets now. 3:39 to go in the second period. Reading trailing this one 3-1. They are on the power play right now. Kevin Tobin on the draw with Hickey. It's one behind the net to O'Rourke for Hingham. O'Rourke up the near side. Flips it to center, doesn't get all of it. Jay Gallagher intercepts it with his foot over to Mealy, quickly to Kevin Tobin, quickly behind the net. Gordon pounds it around. It's going to come to the stick of Jay Gallagher. Gallagher trying to find Riley. It goes all the way into the corner. Nice play by Michael Tobin to hustle. And now Hingham able to scale it the length of the ice and kill more penalty time. We're down to 10 seconds to go on the man advantage for the Rockets. One last rush from here, perhaps. Good forecheck by Drew Hickey. Right one-on-one on Kevin Tobin. And now it's loose, and the penalty to Hennessy is over. So Hingham has killed off their second one of the period. Reading unable to score on the power play. Here's O'Rourke over the line. O'Rourke inside the circle, right side. Trying to center it for Hennessy. Goes off his stick behind the net. And now Mealy around the boards looking for Michael Tobin. Caroms off to Brendan Donaghy. But all the way back to the Hingham defense to Kornack to O'Rourke's been out there about 3 minutes straight. O'Rourke has to get off the ice. Long pass up for Driscoll. Bounces off the boards. And icing is called here. And O'Rourke's going to stay out there, I guess. Looks like O'Rourke's going to play the whole game. Frankie Higgins on the draw with Brendan Donaghy. Goes to Mark O'Rourke behind the net to Kornack. This is Tommy Kornack, the defenseman, brother of Robbie Kornack, the goaltender. A lot of brother combinations on both these teams. O'Rourke able to get it by Ryan Driscoll and to center. Tango now will follow his interception and try to pick it up, but can't do so at this point. And O'Rourke bounces it near side for Kornack off the boards and in deep. Now Kornack and O'Rourke will change, and out go Jacobs along with 22 Joe Rooney. First shift for Joe on defense. Long pass up for Clark. It's a 2-on-2. Now it's a 3-on-2. Long pass over. Misses connection. But following up smartly, there is Grady getting a shot on net. Nice save by Coughlin. Long pass up. Now they try to spring Kevin Tobin. It's loose on the far side to Ryan Driscoll. Tobin turns and sends it in deep, but intercepted by Jacobs. 1:24 to go. Second period. 3-1 Hingham with the lead. Rooney now behind the net. Funny bounce off the boards. It finally gets to Jacobs, who tries to find Will Kenny on the far side. Kenny behind the net, watched closely by Andrew McKaylee. Hingham able to come up with it. Jacob Clark is tripped up. Play continues. Michael Tobin trying to tiptoe through Jacobs. It stays in the zone. Jacob Clark centering pass right onto the stick of Redding's Tango, who starts it up. Tango, left wing pass for Michael Tobin. We're under a minute to go. 47 seconds left in the second period. Now Donovan turns and cycles to Michael Tobin, trying to hit Donovan back on the give and go. Now behind the net is the pass by Kenny, but intercepted by Michael Tobin. And finally, Jacob Clark flips it high up into the center ice area, and it bounces into the Redding end. Back to get it is Mealy. Mealy for Redding. Up the middle, 23 seconds to go. Long pass misconnects. Icing waved off. Jacobs hammers it around the boards looking for Gordon. And the puck jumps out of the rink into the Redding bench. The faceoff's going to come outside the zone, as it was ruled that a Redding player forced that play out. I believe that was C.J. Hart. C.J. Hart out there with Ryan Gallagher on, rather Jay Gallagher in the middle and James Riley on left wing. Now Tango backhands it in, but can't get it deep. Jay Gallagher knocks it off the boards into the zone, but that's going to be it for the second period here as time runs out, ending the second period of play, a period that saw one goal scored. It was it came early. It was Jack Hennessy with the goal for Hingham 11 seconds into the second period. Assists went to Jake Higgins and Drew Hickey. For Higgins, his second assist of the night, and for Hickey, his first point of the night. So after two periods of play, it is Hingham 3 and Redding 1. Once again, we want to remind you and thank you for watching High School Hockey on My Hockey Live here. Paul McNamara, happy to be bringing you all the action tonight. Kevin Booth is our chief cook and bottle wash, running the show here from production side for SerioVideo.com. We thank Kevin for his great work here tonight. And we want to thank Ed Peduto for hosting us here at Burbank Ice Arena. Ed Peduto, one of the best rink managers around anywhere. And we thank him for having us here tonight, as well as Redding High School, Tom Zaya, the AD, and Mark Daugherty, the coach, and, of course, the folks from Hingham as well. So we'll take a break right here, folks. After two periods of play from Redding, it is Hingham 3, Redding 1. We'll be back with the third period in just a few minutes. Welcome back, everyone, to third period action. Paul McNamara along with Kevin Booth here, live at Burbank Ice Arena. And I get back a little late both periods here and missed a goal in that period and almost missed one here and almost missed another one. But Redding is coming out flying here. They trail it by two as we start the third period. Trying to make something happen fast. Breaking it out is Hickey. Comes wide for Higgins. That's close to offsides, and it is offsides, as Higgins hesitated momentarily at the line as he went wide, causing offsides at the line, as ahead of the play was Drew Hickey going down the middle. Just underway third period of play. Hingham gets it over the line. Jacobs, the wrist shot goes off the side of the glove of the goaltender Coughlin, but a save nonetheless. Now a slap shot from Kornak goes wide. A little bit of a shooting gallery here as Jacob's shot is blocked over there by number 12, Ryan Driscoll. And now Riley knocks it in deep for Redding. Play underway near side. And it's knocked behind the Hingham goal over to Kornak. Tommy Kornak behind Robbie Kornak, his brother, in net. Jacobs now starts up the right wing breakout for Hingham. This is going to be icing as his long pass up looking for Quilty on the far side never had a chance of connecting, and it goes deep into the corner. Faceoff's going to come back down in the Hingham end of the ice to the right of Kornak. On the draw for Redding is Donaghy, 14 against 14, Grady for Hingham. Off the draw, it goes into the deep left wing corner, and a big hit over there by Ryan Melly, his first shift of the night, and he's making his presence known. Grady now knocks it off the boards in deep. Mealy will toss it behind the net to Gigliotti. Gigliotti up the middle looking for Donaghy. He goes off his skates. Here's Mealy with the steal. Mealy in, pokes it towards the net, and it goes wide as well out of his net was Kornak to make that save. Backhander up high by Donaghy. It's loose in front. And spilled on the far side is C.J. Hart. That's a penalty in some rinks, but not here tonight. As icing is whistled now, I'll tell you, Hart was spilled, upended. I think the referees want to make last call here. They didn't make that call. But Redding with some life, some new faces off the bench. Tobin now will square off with Hickey here. Tobin wins it back to Gigliotti. Shot through a screen. Deflected actually off Gordon, the Hingham player. And just missed the net. Mealy now at the line. This is a different Redding team in this third period. Perhaps Hingham came out and thought they just skate through a third period. Not the case. Gordon now trying to get around Gigliotti. Take it to the corner. Centering pass to Hennessy. A shot and a big save there by Coughlin. Hennessy right on the doorstep. Very nice pass from Gordon right on his stick. And Hennessy just one-timed a little snapper that Coughlin had smothered. Tobin and Hickey on the draw now. Goes behind the net, DeVolio. All the way around to Ryan Gallagher. Jay Gallagher. And this is a new line with Jay Gallagher out with the Tobin centering pass in Gallagher's skates. Back to DeVolio, goes off Gallagher's skate. Michael Tobin in the corner, centering pass, blocked by Jacobs. Gallagher on it, Gallagher to Kevin Tobin. Kevin Tobin behind the net to Michael Tobin. Michael Tobin centering pass onto the stick of Hennessy, who gives it over to 18 Quilty. Quilty 1-on-4. Now Driscoll right off the bench, can't find the handle, but quickly over on it is Frankie Higgins. Shot goes wide, centering pass by Quilty, knocked away by the goaltender Coughlin. And now Tobin off the boards, far side to Driscoll. Kevin Tobin has it again. Kevin Tobin looks over to DeVolio near side. DeVolio right down below us. Intercepted by Kornak just on his side of the red line. Puck at center ice now. O'Rourke steps into it. O'Rourke on the go. O'Rourke, a wrister. Great save by Coughlin. What a wrist shot by O'Rourke. Now Frankie Higgins, good job to keep it in. Sticks get high over there. And 18 Quilty with some lumber in the corner. Donovan now can't get it out, and finally they do. They get it over on the far side to Driscoll, but stolen away by O'Rourke. Backhanded pass, Mealy goes down low and boxes it. They're going to call a hand pass on that. Looked to me like it was clean, but the official is waving a hand pass. The faceoff's going to come all the way back down in the Redding end. 11:06 remaining, third period of play here, but this is a different Redding team right now. Hingham 3, Redding 1, but it's been all Redding in the third period so far, 4 minutes in. Brendan Donovan is waved out of there, and stepping in will be Farwell. It's Ryan Driscoll. Kornak keeps it in for Hingham on the far side. Driscoll with it now. Driscoll trying to go off the boards for Donovan. O'Rourke tosses it in deep, delayed offside, but now they clear. And Mealy now walks to the center, a nice pass up to Driscoll, who finds Donovan in the middle, 2-on-1 if they hurry. Donovan loses it off the end of his stick, and O'Rourke back to get it for Hingham. O'Rourke bangs it off the boards to the line, but not out. Conti, big backhander in, and gloved about 3 feet next to his net by Kornack, who will hang on with 10:36 to go in the third period, and Hingham holding on to a narrow two-goal lead. The Tobin line is back out there with Kevin Tobin, Michael Tobin, and Jay Gallagher now. Comes back to Tango, shot saved by Kornack, but he can't hang on. Kevin Tobin on the rebound. Kevin Tobin beats a double team, gets it to DeVolio. DeVolio, a shot blocked by Jacobs, and that hurt. Steve Jacobs is down. He limps over to the bench and changes up. O'Rourke will take his spot. Kevin Tobin now gets away from the forecheck by Gordon. Gets it by Hickey up to Michael Tobin, back to Kevin Tobin. Wrister blocked over there by Jake Higgins, and out comes Hennessy. Hennessy trying to dance through center ice, and O'Rourke picks up the slack. O'Rourke, Kevin Tobin trying to knock it off his stick. Rebound, a score off the rebound. Mark O'Rourke follows the shot by Hennessy, and it's 4-1 Hingham. Coughlin made the first save, and O'Rourke just never stopped from his defense position. Goal's going to come at 5:03 of the third, making it Hingham 4 and Reading 1. We'll see if another assist is added on to Hennessy. It should be, might be Jake Higgins. So they only give one assist, it's to Hennessy. So O'Rourke from Hennessy at 5:03. And we are now in a three-goal game in Hingham's favor, and that's not the way this third period is played. It's been all Reading, but Hingham has the only score of the period right now. O'Rourke backhands it away from the forecheck there by C.J. Hart. Hart and Melly out there now with Brendan Donaghy as their center. This is a energy line, if to say the least, here. Hingham able to get it out of the zone and down deep, and icing is called on the slow trickle of the puck. Finally makes it over the goal line, extended with Gigliotti on the chase. Icing is called with 9:11 to go in the third period. And now a three-goal bigger hill to climb for the Rockets. James Riley out there on the wing now with Donovan in the middle and Ryan Driscoll on the other side. Three right shots out there for Reading. They are facing off against the Grady line for Hingham. It's Grady and Clark on his left, and on the right is John Sullivan, normally a left wing, playing right wing this time. So Coach Messina changing up the lines a little bit with a three-goal lead. Conti overskates, the puck is loose. Batted away now by James Riley off the far boards, and picking it up is Tango, and there's going to be a power play for Reading here as 14, Jack Rady's going to go to the penalty box here for Hingham. He's going to get a slashing call. It's going to come at 6:20 of the third period. A minor for Hingham, and it's going to give Reading their third power play opportunity of the evening. Same power play unit that's played the previous two was out there. Kevin Tobin up front with Michael Tobin and James Riley. Jay Gallagher on one point and big Nick Mealy on the other point. Fighting for it is Michael Tobin, and coming away with it is Hennessy. Hennessy trying to pick his way through Mealy. Mealy hustles back, stolen by Gordon. Jay Gallagher back to help out. Now Hennessy knocks down Tobin. It's loose in front to Gordon. A shot, a save, and a rebound. Play continues. Gordon thought he had a shorthanded goal. Put his arms up, but play continues. Jay Gallagher now over the line, runs into Big Jacobs. Able to get it in deep, and now Hennessy off the boards and off the glass and the length of the ice. And Hingham needs four fresh bodies very badly, and they get it. 48 seconds to go on the power play for Reading. They trail it by three, 7:52 to go in the third period. Puck is knocked in deep by Mealy, goes all the way around, but Michael Tobin leaves it for Gallagher. They try to get it in deep. Here's Gallagher, long wrister, saved by Cornack. Good job by Gallagher to get that through. Michael Tobin is beat, needs a rest as he heads to the bench, and now he's going to stay out there. Seconds to go on the power play. Face off to the left of Cornack in the Hingham end. Kevin Tobin with Frankie Higgins. Puck goes to the backboards. Tobin is tripped up, and O'Rourke able to send it the length of the ice to kill off more penalty time. Mealy back on it. Mealy around to Gallagher. Gallagher with 13 seconds to go now on power play time. Mealy trying to find Kevin Tobin. Sends it up to Michael Tobin. Bounces over his stick into the Hingham end, and turning and firing is Drew Hickey up into the netting with 1 second to go on the penalty to Hingham. See what line comes up for Reading. It's going to be that newly formed energy line. It's like Melly and Hart with Donaghy in the middle. Hennessy will take the draw for Hingham. He's able to win it behind the net for Matt Kenny. Out of the box is Grady, and quickly off the bench is Dentremont. Fireside bang on the boards across the way. And Giuliani now trying to get it away from Brian Daugherty, number 11 in red. His first shift of the evening. Jacobs turns and is run into by Melly. By Hart, rather, been able to get it out. Comes all the way up to McGagan. McGagan is spilled, and it's going to be offsides on the play with 6:39 to go in the third period. That was C.J. Hart, 16, not Melly, 3, on that last call in the Hingham end. The Tobin line back out there. Kevin and Michael Tobin and Jay Gallagher now. This really newly formed line in the third period tonight. They bang it off the boards, far side. Jacobs for Hingham. Up the boards, but taken there by Kevin Tobin to Michael Tobin. Near side to Giuliani on the go. Giuliani over the line. Wrister blocked on the point. Now rebound by Gallagher on the follow-up. Goes off the goaltender and up into the netting. Whistle goes with 6:21 to go now. Third period. Jack Giuliani with a good rush there. Was blocked momentarily by Matt Kenny, but gave an opportunity for Jay Gallagher. Gallagher on the draw, knocks it off the boards, out past Mealy. Now they get it to Kevin Tobin. Kevin Tobin, cross point to number 6, Mario Cutone. Puck is deep in there, Hingham end. They swing it around near side, looking for Brian Daugherty. And it comes out of the stick of Dentremont. Will Dentremont gets it over the line in deep and will go to change with under 6 minutes to go now. Cutone now up the middle onto the stick of Donovan. Donovan over the line, 1-on-3 far side. Donovan behind the net now. Comes near side, but picked up here by Ben Minken for Hingham. And now picking it up is Frankie Higgins over the line. Higgins trying to get it in deep. Brendan Tedeschi on it in the corner. Some new names out there for Hingham right now. Puck is kept in by 33, Caleb Wooden. They get it behind the net. Mealy on it for Reading. Mealy will toss it around the left wing boards, intended for Ryan Driscoll. Driscoll up the middle, and a big hit here on Michael Tobin. O'Rourke takes off looking for open ice on the far side. O'Rourke over the line, dumps it in deep. Seconds ticking away, 5:09 to go now. Hennessy on the forecheck. Can't do any damage. Gordon intercepts at center ice, 27 for Hingham. Watched by 27, Donovan for Reading, and now puck is knocked down, and Riley's backhand is picked off by Higgins. He sends Hennessy away over the line. Hennessy, shot saved by Coughlin there. A good one on a good wrist shot bid by Jack Hennessy, who already has a goal on the night. They battle on the far side. Hennessy in the middle to Hickey. Hickey knocked down by Tango, and now Jake Higgins steps into a slap shot that goes wide. Puck loose on the far side. Now finally picked up by Tango. Tango can't get it by the shin pads of Hennessy. And Gordon tries to head to the middle. Tango loses his stick. And now Tango kicks it behind the net. It goes off the side of the cage. The puck is loose dangerously there, and Gigliotti smartly clears it out of there off the glass. Icing waved off as the clock winds down to 4:05 to go now. Gordon able to get a strand of tape on that one to negate the icing. Puck off the boards for Hart. He can't control. Jacob steps into it, and now Grady's going to go to the box again as he knocks down Hart from behind. He's going to get an interference call. It's going to come at 11:09, so Grady's second trip to the box this period. Grady with a goal in the game, two penalties. Just needs an assist. Faceoff back down in the Hingham end. Another Reading power play here. This will be their fourth of the evening. They have nothing to show for the first three. Kevin Tobin now behind the net to Jay Gallagher. Gallagher will start the power play up. Near side to Mealy over the red line. Mealy over the blue line. Tosses it in deep to himself. Mealy behind the net, watched by O'Rourke. Mealy kicks it, trying to get it to Michael Tobin. And it comes loose to Hennessy, who skates it out for Hingham. Hennessy, in no rush, gets it over the red line and dumps it softly in deep. 52 seconds to go on the power play. Kevin Tobin with room. Kevin Tobin, near side to Michael Tobin. Over the line, Michael Tobin tried to take it on his forehand and got it poked off his stick by Jacobs at the last minute. Behind the net, puck on the net, but they'll play it. Michael Tobin trying to pick it up, and instead Jacobs calmly ices it to kill more time. Half a minute to go on the Reading power play here. They trail it by three, 2:47 to go in the third period. Jay Gallagher to Kevin Tobin. Long pass up, intended for Riley, who redirects it in deep. Onto the stick of Jake Higgins, who just sends it the length of the ice, and Kevin Tobin hits it above the shoulders, and the whistle goes. Faceoff will come back down to the Reading end to the right of goaltender Coughlin. 12 seconds left on the power play for Reading. 2:32 remaining in the third period. Hingham with a three-goal lead. They send Hennessy and Gordon back out there. Higgins and number seven, Joe Jacobs, now out on defense for Hingham. Puck in the corner. Hennessy does a good job. Penalty is over. Hingham back to even strength. Reading unable to convert on any of four power plays tonight. Here's a steal. Potential breakaway for Jack Stanton. But Higgins catches him from behind. Hennessy back to get it. Hennessy circles away now. Looks up the middle. Long pass up for Jacobs, or rather for Grady, out of the penalty box. Grady, a shot. Nice save by Coughlin. Very close to the spot where Grady scored from in the first period. On a similar shot, this time Coughlin able to cut that minute space and make a nice save. Higgins goes over to defense partner Jacobs. Joe Jacobs over the line, sends it in just wide of the net. Coughlin will leave it there for Tango. Tango trying to get it up the boards for Michael Creamer. Can't connect. Creamer out there now with Kranich and Jack Stanton. They get it up to Stanton, to Kranich. Kranich up over the red line, run into by Wooden there. Caleb Wooden, the sophomore, number 33. And they send it in deep now with 1:07 to go in the third period. Puck loose in the Hingham end, covered up by Tommy Kornack. Kornack is watched closely by Brendan Donaghy. Kornack now tosses it far side to Jacob Clark, rather. Jacob Clark's pass intended for John Sullivan. This is Sullivan 24. It's a 1-on-4. He's ridden into the corner by Conti. They get it to Brendan Donaghy. They get it out but can't control it. Pat McGagan for Hingham tosses it back to Wooden, who knocks it in deep. Half a minute to go in the third period. Around on the far side to CJ Hart. Hart trying to find Melly on the cross ice pass. Misses connection there. Back to get it is Wooden. Banks it off the boards to center ice. Conti rips a wrister. It's a delayed offside. And Melly touches up, and they'll blow the whistle here with 14:02 to go in the third period. And Hingham leading it 4-1. Good job by both coaches to get a lot of players in tonight, late in the third period of a three-goal game. Higgins takes a face-off here with Daniel Kranich, the sophomore, or the junior, rather. Kranich, a junior. Redding dumps it in deep. Back to get it for Hingham is Joe Rooney. Rooney can't find the handle. Higgins helps out. He takes a bump there from Michael Creamer, but the buzzer goes, ending this one. The final score will read the Hingham Harbormen 4 and the Redding Rockets 1. We'll recap this one quickly, but first we want to say thank you as you watch the team shake hands here. We want to thank Sullivan Tire. If you're looking for exceptional auto service, head on down to Sullivan Tire. Family owned and operated, they've been serving New England for over 60 years. Their highly trained staff will give you a hand with any of your auto needs. Sullivan Tire offers brand name tires and parts at a price that can't be beat. They're always here to get you there. Sullivan Tire and Auto Centers. And the Department of Recreation and Conservation. The Mass Department of Conservation and Recreation is actively recruiting lifeguards to fill summer lifeguard jobs. If you are a qualified swimmer and are interested in applying for a summer lifeguard position, this is a great opportunity to do what you love and make $1,060 every 2 weeks. Visit masslifeguard.com to register today. And we want to thank Mohawk Rubber Sales for jumping on board with My Hockey Live again. Mohawk Rubber Sales, we thank them for their sponsorship and their support, and we'll have more to say about them as the season progresses. Mohawk Rubber Sales, proud sponsor of My Hockey Live. Once again, we want to thank everyone here at Burbank Ice Arena, Ed Peduto, the general manager. Can't find a better guy on the North Shore or anywhere. Ed Peduto, we thank him for his hospitality tonight, to AD Tom Zaya, head coach Mark Doherty from Reading. Thanks for having us in to carry this one on My Hockey Live. And, of course, Coach Tony Messina and his staff, always good to deal with from a perspective of coaches and friends of the game. So we thank them. Once again, tip of the hat to Charlie Driscoll, who would have been here tonight. Meant so much to high school hockey over the years. Coach, you're with us in spirit forever, kid. Well, thank you all for being with us at My Hockey Live. Tell your friends. Subscriptions are still available for the year. And we got a lot more hockey to go. Check the website at myhockeylive.com. Tell your friends, spread the word. Great to have you on board here at myhockeylive.com. And if your high school wants to have a game done, contact myhockeylive.com. And sponsorship packages are available on a game by game or a package of games or for the rest of the season. Thanks again for watching. For Kevin Booth, who did a terrific job tonight for SerioVideo.com. For Mark Igo, Jake Levin, Amanda Bokshen, everybody at My Hockey Live, and June West, of course, who makes it all go. Speaking of Hingham fans, we thank June for her day-to-day support throughout the year at My Hockey Live. So for everyone at My Hockey Live, I'm Paul McNamara saying thanks for being with us. The final score, once again, Hingham 4, Reading 1. We'll see you next time on MyHockeyLive.com.